visitor. What? I'm never clear on what the difference is. They used to be. Okay. Is she a visitor or a guest? Sister Hillbabet.
She's a guest.
She's a guest. Yes. All right. Yes. Sister Babette, we welcome you this morning. She's going to give us some words of exhortation. We're just excited that she's here this morning.
I have you to know I'm family.
That's who I am.
All right. Amen. I would like everyone to stand up and let's give God some praise. Woo! This morning. Amen. Come on. My husband and I are here on vacation, kind of, sort of vacation, and did not know that I would make it here on Sunday this morning. So I just thank him for his orchestrating that, for working that out. And I was just asked to bring you a word of encouragement, and I'm going to be very, very brief. But I noticed that the theme is that the ladies are precious in the sight of God. Amen. And you know, if you compare Christianity to other beliefs, I won't really say religion because we know that true Christianity is a relationship. Amen? But if you compare with other beliefs, Jesus is the only one who elevated the status of the woman. Everyone else put them down. You know. And even the Jewish prayer at one time was, God, thank you for not making me either a dog or a woman. But I want you to know I saw that face up there. Like, but I want you to know that Jesus finds you precious.
Amen.
You are precious in his sight. Amen. And if you think of those things that are precious to you, they have value. Amen. They have worth. They meet a need. Amen. And I want to encourage the ladies that that is who God has made us to be, those who can meet a need. And just real quick, I promise to be out because I want to hear the word myself. Amen. From Sister Candy. But in St. John, you don't have to turn to it if you don't want to. St. John 4:10, Jesus, very familiar passage. Jesus is talking to the Samaritan woman. And he says, Jesus said that if you knew the gift of God, who it is that asked of you to give me a drink, you would have asked him and he would have given you living water. And then skipping to 13 and 14, Jesus said that whosoever drinks of the water in this well, this physical well, will thirst again. But whoever drinks of the water that I give him will never thirst. But the water that I give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life. And ladies, I want to encourage you, and of course the gentlemen too, that the Lord God of all gods has given you a resource that does not run dry.
Amen.
Amen. Sometimes we don't feel precious because we don't think we can meet a need. But whatever the need is, God has enabled you to do it. Amen. Amen. You are precious. Amen. God has women placed in positions of prayer, of intercession, Amen. Of leadership. Amen. Of training, of teaching, of nurturing, of raising of children. And you have a well, a resource in you that does not run out.
Amen.
Amen. And even when that phone call comes in the middle of the night that you did not expect, he's right there. Amen.
Amen.
You already have that resource within you, ladies, because you are precious. You can meet a need. Amen. The Bible says in a couple of places that the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, for he has anointed me. Come on, to bring good news unto who? The poor.
Yes.
And who's poor? Whoever has a need.
That's it.
Whoever has a need. Amen. I was saying that my husband and I were here sort of on vacation. I was tasked to officiate a wedding yesterday in another part of Oklahoma. And as the minister and the one doing the premarital counseling and all of that, that was work for me. It was not really necessarily fun. And then as things begin to come to a head, the wedding was canceled. Yes, I see your faces. The wedding was canceled. But even walking them through that process, amen, we have to believe that God has the resources for us to give to them.
Yeah.
Amen, because we're precious in his sight. Come on, amen?
Amen.
Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand prayer. Come on, let's pray.
Give me a spirit of fear, and I just totally said to him, no, that will not happen. I'm going to do the things that are common sense or practical that I'm supposed to do.
Yes.
But the angel, the Bible still says, the angels of the Lord are encamped about us because we are precious in his sight. Hallelujah. I just wanted to share that with you. That's just my little testimony. I'm one of the devil tonight.
Yes.
Sometimes when you keep silent about a thing, he might think you're scared. You don't understand. You don't have the victory. But I have the victory. I have the victory this morning. Sister Prayer, will you come with your lovely, lovely self and give us this morning's announcements?
Amen.
Good morning, Northside. Also have a testimony that I would like to share, and it's something that God performed a miracle for someone, and I would like to share it with you. Jonathan, could you bring Candace down there? And y'all, she's kind of frightened, so we have to welcome her. Just stand right there. Right there. They have been coming pretty steadily, pretty faithfully for the past few weeks.
That's right.
And about 2 or 3 weeks ago, my son rededicated his life to Christ. Amen. And that is so good to me.
Amen.
And on Wednesday, Jonathan was asking the pastor a question after Bible study, and we got in the car to take him home. And he continued with the questions, and the Lord led me down the path of salvation for Candace.
Praise
God. So I explained the plan of salvation, and I asked her, Candace, would you like to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior? And she said, yes.
Praise
God.
And
so she accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior.
Faithful you are in what he's given you.
Y'all get that?
Yeah. Right.
Say it again, baby.
I'm going to say it again. God measures success in how faithful you are in what he's given you.
That's good.
And from Malachi 3:10, or Malachi, which means messenger. So, this is the message. Bring all the tithes into the storehouse, so there will be enough food in my temple. If you do, says the Lord Almighty, I will open up windows of heaven for you. I will pour out a blessing so great, you won't have enough room to take it in.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
It's like, that just brought shivers down my spine when I read that. And the blessing is today is for to youth to get this. If I will pour out a blessing so great, this is what the Lord is telling us, so great that you won't have enough room to take it in. And then it says, try it. Let me prove it to you. Okay?
Yes.
So, as we bow our heads today in prayer, I just want to pray for the youth to get this. So, Lord, we come to you today just thanking you for who you are, Heavenly Father. We thank you for allowing us to bring you the first fruits because we love this part of the service, the joy of giving.
Yeah.
Heavenly Father, we don't want to be greedy, but we want to be grateful for your goodness and your mercy.
Yeah.
And, oh, Lord, we ask you to multiply it back into our lives as the praises go up and the blessings come down. Heavenly Father, we want to multiply back in 100-fold.
Amen.
So, Lord, we give you all.